13-year-old boy presents to your pediatric clinic complaining of episodic burning pain in his hands, feet, arms, and legs after playing soccer. And these painful episodes occur only after strenuous exercise or when he is sick with the flu. The flu is mainly because of viral. So during viral attacks as well as strenuous exercise during physical exertion, he is getting these type of episodic burning pain, that is painful episodes. On physical examination, you notice telangiectatic skin lesions, especially on the back, which are dark red, punctate, non-blanching with pressure. You need to write down this. Telangiectatic lesions on his back, which are dark red. The type of the lesion, the color, the morphology is extremely important for us to identify, because sometimes they may give you the picture also. He states that these lesions have grown in size and become more numerous over the years. The nature of the lesion is extremely important. Dark red, punctate, non-blanching with pressure, telangiectatic lesions. So his neurological examination is normal, and you order a battery of serum studies which shows elevated blood urea nitrogen and creatinine, suggesting that the patient's kidneys are damaged. So what are the clues what we need to take from this case? 13-year-old boy, episodic burning pain after playing soccer, that is physical exertion, or after flu-like attacks. Next is telangiectatic lesions on his back, which are dark red, punctate, non-blanching with pressure. Next is patient's kidneys are damaged because of elevation of the blood urea nitrogen, creatinine, right? Yeah. This is what is the case. After this, whatever I am giving you is the clue, and you won't see this in the real exam. You believe that he may be suffering from an X-linked recessive disorder that is associated with a lysosomal enzyme deficiency, and you prescribe phenytoin, carbamazepin for treatment of his painful burning episodes while you await further genetic testing. So by this point where the patient's kidneys are damaged, the case is over. By this point, you should be in a position to identify what exactly we are talking about. And all these are the clue points for you to analyze what exactly it is. It is an X-linked recessive disorder associated with a lysosomal enzyme deficiency, a very big clue in this case. And mainly, you already prescribed phenytoin and carbamazepin for the treatment of the painful burning episodes while you avoid further genetic testing. It is the Fabry's disease. It is an X-linked recessive disorder caused by the deficiency of an enzyme called as alpha-galactosidase A. X-linked recessive, alpha-galactosidase A. And this alpha-galactosidase A is the lysosomal enzyme responsible for the cleavage of the terminal alpha-galactosyl moiety from globotriaosylceramide. I'm repeating once again. Alpha-galactosidase A is the lysosomal enzyme responsible for the cleavage of the terminal alpha-galactosyl moiety. Terminal alpha-galactosyl moiety from globotriaosylceramide, or which is also called as globotriaosylceramide. And another name for this is trihexosylceramide. Trihexosylceramide. In simple language, we can say that removal of the alpha-galactosyl moiety from the trihexosylceramide can be done by alpha-galactosidase A, which is the lysosomal enzyme. And this is a very important key step and a regulatory step of the glycosphingolipid metabolism. Glycosphingolipid metabolism. Now, whenever this enzyme is deficient, ceramide trihexoside is the product. ceramide trihexoside is the product, which is also called as a globotriaosylceramide, accumulates. Globotriaosylceramide, it is also called as ceramide trihexoside. This product accumulates in the skin, heart, kidneys, CNS. Because of involvement of the kidneys, there's renal failure. Involvement of the skin, skin lesions, CNS, leading to abnormal function of these organs. And what are the abnormal functions? We will discuss in the clinical manifestations. So this disease starts approximately by the age of 10 and predominantly seen in the male gender. So the disease present in the childhood approximately by the age of 10 typically initially starts with the angiokeratomas. So the age over here is 13. Angiokeratomas are seen in this case, and these angiokeratomas are nothing but called as a telangiectatic lesions. These are skin lesions, and there will be acroparesthesia and hypohidrosis, sweating less than usual, hypohidrosis. So these angiokeratomas are not large, and these angiokeratomas are small. Yeah, so the nature of the lesions, if you see on the back, which are dark red, punctate, non-blanching with pressure, which means the punctated lesions are typically small. There's a reason you need to mention that these angiokeratomas are small. They are punctate, dark red to bluish black lesions. So you also write blue-black. Not only the dark red, some cases you may also see the blue-black lesions. And they do not blanch with the pressure is the marker. Now, as I already mentioned, that it generally begins by the age of 10. So by the age of 13, he should have approximately more telangiectatic lesions and should be bigger in size. So whenever you see the size of these lesions are like larger when compared to that of the small punctated telangiectatic lesions, you have to think that these lesions grow with the size along with the age. So here, increase in size as well as in number with the age. That's what we mentioned here. He states that these lesions have grown in size and become more numerous over the years. Why he mentioned over the years? Which means already from 10 years, he's developing this. There's a reason in the history is very important. Lesions have grown in size, become more numerous over the years. We'll tell you that started by the age of 10. So that's the reason. Next one is the acroparesthesia is another important clinical manifestation in this case, in the Fabry's. So this acroparesthesia is the one presents as episodic burning pain. Acroparesthesia presents as episodic burning pain of hands, feet, and proximal extremities. Hands, feet, and proximal extremities. That is precipitated by the exercise, fatigue, or fever. Acroparesthesia presents as episodic burning pain. So we already seen that episodic burning pain in hands, feet, arms, legs after playing soccer. Or painful episodes occur only after strenuous exercise or when he is sick or with the flu. Which means we should know that these episodic burning pain of the hands, feet, as well as proximal extremities precipitated by the exercise, fatigue, or fever. Next important manifestation. Till now we studied the manifestations, like one is hypohidrosis, you mentioned it, angiokeratomas, you mentioned it, and acroparesthesia is the third clinical manifestation, and the fourth one is the corneal and lenticular lesions. Corneal and lenticular lesions, here they did not give, right? So it's not compulsory that they have to give all the clinical manifestations in one single case. But you may also see corneal and lenticular lesions. Whenever you think that it is the Fabry's, try to identify these four: angiokeratomas, hypohidrosis, acroparesthesia, corneal as well as lenticular lesions, which are well detected by the slit lamp examination. Slit lamp examination. And there will be atortosity of the conjunctival as well as retinal vessels. Conjunctival and retinal vessels. And because of the involvement of the kidney as well as involvement of the heart, there will be heart failure as well as renal failure in most advanced cases. So what do you mean by the advanced cases, which means how many years it will develop to get these advanced cases? Approximately, the advancement of the Fabry disease mainly depends upon the every individual, that is immune status of the person, but generally it will take the course of 3 to 5 years to develop these renal failure as well as heart failure. Because if you see this case once again, which shows elevated blood urea nitrogen and creatinine, suggesting that the patient kidneys are already damaged by the age of 13, which means after 3 years from the initial attack, his kidneys are damaged. Here they did not mention about manifestations of the heart failure, but he may be having the heart failure, which is they did not mention in this case. Okay, so you have to know that it will take years, approximately 3 to 5 years, where the patients may eventually develop heart failure as well as renal failure. Now, what are the lab findings? The lab findings are best evident with elevated serum blood urea nitrogen and creatinine. And you may ask, what if there is no signs and symptoms of renal failure? What about if the patient is 11 years of age or 10.5 years? Initially, he developed these angiokeratomas, hypohidrosis, acroparesthesia, and lenticular lesions. Generally, at that time, they are like asymptomatic. Only with the painful episodic burning pain is present, but majority of the cases, they are like mistaken as normal general rashes. Because these rashes are very small and punctate, they are not also growing in size. So majority of the cases, they left unidentified. Only when the symptomatology becomes very severe after 1 to 2 years, when the patient is getting this episodic burning pain after the fever or continuously after the physical exertion, then by that time there will be increased lab levels of elevated creatinine as well as blood urea nitrogen. Right? So that's how it is. That's the reason it is not compulsory that you will see the lab findings in this case. But if it is a symptomatic disease, then you have to look for elevation of blood urea nitrogen as well as creatinine. And what is the treatment? Already they gave that in the case as a clue, but in your real exam they won't give you this. You prescribe phenytoin and carbamazepine. Why? Mainly for those acroparesthesia, that is burning, episodic burning pain of his hands, feet. Mainly for you are giving the phenytoin and carbamazepine. And what you will do for the kidney failure? Dialysis and kidney transplantation for the renal failure. That's it. And this Fabry disease comes under what category of diseases? Glycosphingolipidosis. Fabry's, Gaucher's, name and picks. All these three comes under classified as neutral glycosphingolipidosis. Neutral. FGN. FGN. Fabry's, Gaucher's, Niemann-Pick disease are classified as neutral glycosphingolipidosis. So this is the case of Fabry's disease.